What's more important, the boots or the ball?
I mean, to be fair, you kind of need both, so.
So here's the situation. You have $200 to spend on football boots and a ball. Should you spend more of that money on the ball or more of that money on the boots? This is a tricky question because I feel like a lot of people these days prioritize the wrong things. I think the answer that most people would give is that the boots are far more important than spending a lot of money on a match ball, as an example. But I tend to disagree, and I'm going to explain why. Obviously, football boots are extremely important. I've essentially dedicated my life over the last 6 years to reviewing football boots and giving you the best possible information. Some are definitely better than others. Of course, everyone has their opinion on how important they are, but ideally you want boots that are good quality, that are comfortable, that fit you well, that have the proper performance characteristics. Having the right stud pattern is also very important, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you need to spend a lot of money to get all of those things. Now, I think it's pretty obvious why football boots are important. But what about the ball? Well, one, you need it to play this sport. Without it, you are pretty much out of luck unless you have an extremely vivid imagination. Two, if you're going to be training in an effort to get better, you're going to want a good quality ball that's not only going to perform the part, but also be fairly durable. And far too often do I see guys with top of the line $300 boots and then the cheapest possible $15 to $20 ball that they can find that's completely beat up and doesn't even have proper air. That, in my opinion, is totally backwards. Now, in my opinion, and feel free to share your own down below in the comments, if the situation had to be an expensive ball and cheap boots, or expensive boots and a cheap ball, I would pick an expensive ball with cheap boots every single time. If you could give me an official match ball and a pair of $50 to $60 Nike Tiempo Legend 7 Academies, I would be perfectly happy. And here's why. The ball is everything. The sport, after all, is called football. There's also an S word for the sport, but I'm not gonna say it because I don't wanna trigger anybody. For me, what makes a high quality ball so much different than a cheap one is the consistency. And that's why match balls are taken so seriously at the professional level. If you've ever noticed, when teams play in their league, before playing in that league game, all the training sessions leading up to that, they use that exact same ball that they're going to use in the match. And then once they go to the Champions League, all the games leading up to that Champions League match, they train with the Champions League ball. And that's because even high-end match balls, they all have a slightly different feel to them. And it's important to get used to that feel, to have that consistency, and I guess that muscle memory to a certain extent in regards to what you need to expect with the ball once you make contact with it. And I think what an ideal situation is for you specifically, if you're looking to invest in a higher quality ball, is if you play in a league, specifically one that uses the exact same match ball in every single match, have that exact same match ball for training. That is an ideal situation. And even if your league doesn't use the same ball in every single match, I still think there's a lot of value to spending the extra money on a higher end match ball. If it's FIFA approved, I think that's kind of an ideal situation. As much as I think the FIFA approved system is a bit of a scam, the balls that are FIFA approved pretty much always tend to be very, very good quality. They perform the part, they're more consistent, and they end up being a lot more durable as well. So longevity is also going to be very, very good. And that's not to say that you should go out and spend $165 on the latest and greatest match ball. In fact, I would pretty much never recommend doing that unless you just have a lot of extra cash. The beauty of having so many match balls these days is that there's always last season's match ball and the season before that, available online at extremely low discounted prices, typically 50, 60, 70% off sometimes. So for $80, $70, $60, you can get that top of the line match ball that I can assure you, even if it's last year's or the year before's model, it's gonna feel and pretty much be exactly the same as the current one. While these companies would like you to believe that the latest and greatest tech is way better than the old one, when it comes to official match balls, there just isn't that much variety. And then with whatever money you have left over, that's when you wanna go out and pick out your boots. And even if you are on a budget, you still wanna do your research because certain models are better than others as far as quality and just what you're getting as an overall package. That's what channels like this exist for, so you can do your research and have a good idea of what you're getting into prior to making your purchase. But I would say that for the most part, when you're talking about allocating budget towards the boots
and the ball. The ball is more of a necessity item, where the boots are more of a luxury item. You want them to fit well, you want them to be comfortable, you want them to be the right boots for the playing surface you're gonna be using them on, but you can achieve that comfort, you can achieve all of those things without spending $300. If you have the extra money to spend, top of the line boots are the best. They're going to offer the best experience. But again, if you're on a tight budget and trying to decide whether you should spend more on the ball or more on the boots, I would pretty much always recommend spending more on the ball. But that's just my opinion. Let me know what yours is down below in the comments. And if you have any questions regarding this topic at all, feel free to ask them down below in the comments and I'll be happy to help you out. If you enjoyed the video, found it helpful and informative, be sure to support it with a like, perhaps share it with a friend if you know that they're struggling with this particular question. Also, if you're not subscribed already, I upload a new video every single day. So if you don't want to miss out on future videos on all the latest and greatest soccer gear, be sure to hit that subscribe button along with the little bell notification so you get notified every single time a new video goes live. All my social media information is linked down below in the description as well if you want to follow me in any of those places. Other than that though, guys, thank you so much for watching and we'll see you in the next one.